And you know, I've got three granddaughters, and I remember one year buying each of them an umbrella, and I thought, Grandma, you have arrived.
And not only that, but so have the kids.
There you go. And hey, you know what? They didn't even realize it.
That's great. Yeah, they thought, well, it was an umbrella.
How about an umbrella? But that just, when you talking about back then, I just thought about that. And I remember Papa sending me to the company store with a dime to get a Coke, which was 6 cents.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, now come right back. But they had this huge counter of candy. And I got the excess pennies, you know, the four pennies. And an hour later, I'd come in, and Papa said, where have you been? And I said, well, Papa, I got your Coke. I know you have my Coke, honey, but where have you been? It, you know, I sent you an hour ago. But, Papa, look what I got. It took me an hour to choose from all, you know, pennies.
Been shopping, Daddy.
Yes, sir. That's it. So I just wanted to share that with you.
Isn't it funny looking back on this? Different people, different views, but you thought an umbrella was the last word in a status symbol.
Exactly.
Isn't that fun?
And I wonder where Harriet Powell is today.
I don't know, but I hope she's still got that pretty umbrella.
Oh, honey, she's probably got many, many more since then. That thing would have had to have deteriorated. Have a good day.
You be
thank
sweet.
You.
Good to talk to you.
You too.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Cohutta, Georgia, and Frank on the radio. Hello, Frank.
Yo, Lilo, how you doing?
I'm doing good, buddy. How you doing?
Good.
Good.
I want to tell you about what I thought people was rich.
All right.
My sister had a girlfriend, and she was all the time talking about how rich they was, you know. And I thought rich people was happy. But one day we went to their house, and all the siblings were fighting just like we did. And I looked around the house, and they had about the same kind of furniture we did. And the car wasn't much different from ours. And they invited us to eat dinner with them, you know.
Uh-huh.
And we went ahead to eat dinner, and they had just about the same kind of food we did, you know. So I was real disappointed.
I understand.
Well, that's all I wanted to say, Lilo.
All right, buddy, you take care of yourself. Good call. 1-800-572-8255, our cleaning woman from Cleveland, Tennessee. What do you say, young lady?
Good morning to you, Ludlow.
How you doing?
I'm fine.
Good.
If I have time, remind me to tell you a real quick funny at the end of this.
All right.
That lady, Miss Ruth, that was the poor little rich girl.
Yeah.
Didn't she sound like a nice person?
Great lady.
I would love to meet her sometime.
Yeah, yeah.
Not spoiled at all.
No, as a matter of fact, she felt a little shortchanged.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, but doesn't that just go to show you that we thought that would be the last word?
Oh, yeah.
Have anything you wanted, and yet we didn't know what we had. I didn't realize what a privilege I had before monster brothers to grow up with,
mm-hmm.
and a sister.
Yeah, but they were built-in companions.
Well, that's true. You know, I told you how we played church.
Mm-hmm.
We had a congregation and everything, no problem, you know, because there were so many others.
Yeah.
Several things I thought were just the last word. White eggs, because we had chickens and all I ever got was brown eggs.
Oh,
and now you pay more for brown eggs.
That's funny.
Isn't that something?
That's funny. Isn't it funny what you notice at that age?
Also, milk in a carton from the store, because I milked those stupid cows,
mm-hmm.
and we drank that old foamy milk. I thought getting it at the store would just be so cool.
Downtown, yeah. And now you drive a long way for some fresh milk.
Oh, don't you know it? I love the taste of fresh milk. A clothes dryer, you know, we never had a clothes dryer growing up. We had a wringer washer for years.
Yeah.
I'm only 40, and we had a wringer washer.
Yeah.
And then we got a regular wash machine, but we never had a dryer until I got married, you know. Pancake syrup out of a bottle. My mother always made pancake syrup, and I know now that it was much, much better.
Yeah, but you thought to get that out of a bottle would be a rich thing.
I wanted Aunt Jemima. I wanted that little bottle that looked like a person.
Mm-hmm.
Pour it out of it. Not an old cup where she poured it off the pot and the stove.
Yeah.
A couple of problems I had.
All right.
Eyebrows. I have one big eyebrow that grew across the top of my eyes.
Oh, that's awful.
I was not allowed to pluck it at all.
No?
No, not until I got to be a teenager, you know. But as I always looked like I was frowning because there it was, you know. I hated that.
Yeah.
I was so embarrassed. And also, because I never wore shoes, either riding a bike or just walking down the road, I never remember there a time when I did not have the end of one of my big toes scabbed off.
And I can remember the pain.
Oh,
of
it
that.
Hurt.
And when you got in the bathtub with that, it was just awful.
Yowza. Oh, you scream, but I wouldn't wear shoes. No way. No way. And also the last thing, I thought that if anybody else, well, we were so poor because, you know, in school you'd have to bring a present for a boy or a girl, whatever, at Christmas. And the only thing we ever got to take was a box of chocolate-covered cherries, always. And I was so embarrassed by that. And what I didn't know was all the kids wanted that. Yeah, they were hoping they would get our present.
That was the best one.
They never got a whole box of candy to devour.
Not by themselves, never.
No.
Never.
Have you got time for that funny, or shall I save it for another day?
Save it for another day.
Okay.
All right. I'll talk
to you later.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. More conversation right after this. I want to talk to you about my buddies at Taylor Construction.
Well, living up there in Detroit City, sometimes us little ones would get homesick for Harlan County. The old Dad Burns would take him, put us on his knee, had a big old long knee, and he'd put us all on there and call Ma and say, "Oh, come on in here and listen to me sing this song about my girl."
I got some sugar on a cloudy day.
1-800-572-8255, Hogansville, Georgia, and Speck on the radio. Hello, Speck.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How you doing, old friend?
Oh, just wonderful. Just working away.
Good for you.
Yes. And thinking about when people were very wealthy, when I was a child, I was very envious of a girlfriend I had. They had a huge bathtub, and she took bubble baths.
Oh, yeah, like in the movies.
God, and I went, this is fabulous. But I never got to take one. You know, that was kind of crummy. I never got to take that bubble bath.
Yeah. It just looked at her from afar because
All
the good movie stars had a picture in bubble baths.
Yeah, and it was so fabulous. You know, they had this huge bathroom.
Mm-hmm.
And this huge, huge bathroom. Well, it looked huge. It, you know, probably regular size.
Yeah.
And she put all this stuff in it, you know, and she really, all this oil and stuff. And I'd sit there and I'd think, God, that'd be fabulous to do that. But now I take bubble baths.
Yeah, there you go. Now, it's your turn now.
It's my turn to say, oh, what a big bathtub with bubble baths.
Put all that good smelling stuff in there. The whole house smells like a funeral.
Well, I try to get the kind that doesn't smell. I can't stand the scent. And I tell you something else with summer camp. You know, a lot of kids in the community, maybe one or two, could go to summer camp.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought, how can they do that? You know, I didn't even know they even had summer camp, but they'd come back and they'd talk about, oh, they made this and they swam and they done all this stuff.
Yeah.
And I was so envious of that. Isn't that strange how you, when you're a child, you really want to do that, but you can't.
Yeah, yeah. The thing I remember is they all came back with these plaited pieces of plastic around their neck, and they made necklaces and they, if you know what I'm talking about, the plaited plastic strips.
Yeah, and they had made them as bracelets and little necklaces, and they put something on them.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really wanted one of those.
Yeah, that'd be a great place for a skate key, but I couldn't find my skate key.
Well, I had one experience with skating, and that was the end of my career. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I went skating I was going with my husband at the time, and the girl that he went with was a fabulous skater, and I couldn't skate. But do you think I was going to tell him I couldn't skate?
Oh, heavens, no.
So we went to the skating rink, and, you know, they had the big jukebox at one end, and the thing was all, you know, it was round. They played all this great music. So I don't know how to skate, but I get on there. Well, he could skate backwards and all this. Well, he kind of turned me loose. The next thing I knew, I had a skate in the jukebox.
Oh.
And I said, whoops. Better get off of these darn things.
Yeah, I can look foolish off skates just as well as I can on.
So we never went skating anymore.
Great. That's wonderful. You take care of your sweet self.
All righty. You have a nice day.
Good to hear from you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Hey, visit Charlie Williams Pinecrest Lodge in Athens, Georgia, featuring a 50-item steak, seafood barbecue, and catfish buffet on Friday and Saturday nights. Choo Choo Man, beautiful Dallas, Georgia. Good morning, old friend.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Jennifer Ashland. Happy birthday to you. And that's Hobo Bill's one-year-old granddaughter.
I hope she's listening.
He's got grandchildren up, I guess, some 25 years old, but he's got one year old today.
Well, that's wonderful.
Yeah, he is listening.
Well, that's good.
And that'll just tickle him good.
And I hope that Jennifer's listening, too.
I guess she is. She's a year old, but she's probably listening. Luddy?
Yeah.
Now, I've told you about when I'd go to Atlanta, and I thought everybody in Atlanta was rich because of the bathtub.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you could get in a big bathtub full of water, one of these big old cast iron tubs. You know? and you know, you could run the water all the way to the top. You could almost drown in that thing.
Dive into it.
And that was great.
Yeah.
Well, you know what I hadn't told you was we had one in our house in the country.
Oh, really?
Yeah, big old cast iron bathtub.
Did you ever take a bubble bath?
We never could take a bath in it because you had to draw water and put water in it. We didn't have no pipes. And occasionally, we'd put water in it, but it's just about an inch of water is all you'd get in it.
Just enough to bathe.
Yeah, that wasn't fun.
Choo-choo, got to get out of here, buddy.
All right, have a good one.
I'll talk to you later.
Bye-bye.
We'll be right back. You stay with us.
Yes, I know it's a long, hard road.
Hi, teachers. This is Nicholas D. Ainsworth. You're listening to my close personal friend, Ludlow Porch. And that tickled me nearly about to death.
You're with WBIC 810 AM, Royston, Georgia.
You've seen septic system
Mickey Mouse Club. Let's talk to Double M on the radio.
Oh, good morning and bless you. I'm at a payphone.
Oh.
I was struck with an uncontrollable urge to call you, and I was on my way to Riverdale, and I thought I was going to have to drive flat to Fayetteville to find a payphone.
But you found it.
I found one in front of a liquor store, and I whipped in here like a mad woman, and there was a man coming out. I think he had already had a few. And he jumped straight. I think he thought I was out to get him.
He was getting an early start.
That's right. Well, I always thought that all rich people's money was rusty. Because my mother used to say when I was a little girl, you know, if somebody would continuously answer for rides or want to borrow something or something, she would say, I'm going to spend some of their rusty old money.
So they hung on to it till it rusted.
Absolutely.
That's wonderful.
I thought so too. Now, the other thing, I thought that people that had a couple, like a yard man and a maid that wore uniforms, they were really a step above the people that just had day help.
Oh, they were step above everybody in my neighborhood.
Well, yeah. That's true.
Yeah, because you'd see that in the movies. The butler just so, the maid just so.
Or Hazel, you know.
Yeah, Hazel, that's right. Hazel. Yeah. A sharp dresser.
Absolutely. Well, I am just really enjoying this.
Well, I am glad. You hurry up and get back in your car.
I will. I don't like car phones, so that's the reason I had to find a payphone. If anybody's important enough to talk to, they're important enough to stop.
Aren't you sweet?
Like you.
You take care of your bad self. I'll talk to you
soon.
Bye-bye. Jasper Jeep Gang, no matter where you live, your Jeep dealership is in Jasper, Georgia. Here, let's add to this a little bit. I would like to know, and I guess almost all children, all I knew, had some kind of chores they had to do. You remember? And a lot of them had a lot of chores, before school, after school, instead of school. I want to know which one of those did you just despise? Did you just hate to do? I have heard a lot of stories about, well, we heard the story about the young lady a few minutes ago that had to go out and milk the goats before she could go to school. You heard that one? Doesn't sound like a fun before school. I mean, I wake up very slowly in the morning. And I don't want to milk any goats before I have a bath. Maybe after, but then you got to do it all over again. That sounded like one I would have dreaded and hated. How about yours? Chores. Let me tell you about the worst one that I guess I ever had or thought about having. It was my job in the days and the years before we had a refrigerator. We had an icebox, as everybody did in those days. It was my job to take out the big wash pan from under that thing that held the water from the melting ice. Okay, now, had I been smart, and I was not, had I been smart, I would have known that the sooner I emptied that, the better off it was going to be. If I didn't wait till somebody told me, I was in better shape because it wasn't full. But I thought always I had to wait till it was full or almost full and sometimes overrunning. So, you know the name of that. You would pull that thing out, hold in summertime, no shirt on, hold that close to your little belly, start outdoors to empty that, and of course it would splash up onto your stomach, that cold, icy cold water. And when it did, you would flinch, jump, and then it went on the floor. And what do you think about that? Then you had to go find a mop or what have you. All right, chores. That was my all-time, and that took maybe 30 seconds. That was my all-time hideous chore. And when I had to help with the dishes, didn't mind that much. There was usually some conversation going on, didn't mind that much. And, of course, everybody's chore was when there were clothes on the line. You remember this? When there were clothes on the line and a drop of rain fell, the alarm went out. Everybody in the house, man, woman, child, had to go get those clothes off the line because we knew if they had 3 drops of water on there, it was over. Terrible, terrible. Well, what you were doing, favorite radio show, didn't make any difference. You had to head outside and gather the clothes. That and emptying that cold, cold water, two of the worst things of my life. I've got to read you something if I can find it. This is completely off the topic, but something I just found. I guess politics always fascinates. According to the 1997 platform of the National, I'm sorry, correct that, platform of the Natural Law Party. This was in Canada. This was released in May. People, according to their teachings, people should stop using the south and west entrance to their homes because they are inharmonious and should instead use north and east entrances. Furthermore, Canadians entering the U.S. should do so from Niagara Falls, whose entrance from the east is the only non-southward entrance in the country. The party proposes to eliminate the federal deficit by eliminating problems and to create an invincible national defense through yoga flying, which resembles hopping like a frog. Now, obviously, we're talking about some nuts here, right? These nuts in 1993 got 84,000 votes, and they are going to take care of the federal deficit by eliminating problems. Why didn't we think of that? 1-800-572-8255. I want to talk to you about my buddy's Fairburn Eye Clinic. Listen, look after my whole family. Look after all our eyes because I'm convinced that's the best care available. They're the ones that discovered the little cataract I had and had to have removed, and they looked after me like I was somebody. I mean, walked me through this thing, easy as pie. And I had a rehabilitation time of about 8 minutes or something like that. Easy as in. These folks have been in the same location, Fairburn Eye Clinic, for 30 years. So what you need to do, whether you need a simple eye exam, new glasses, contacts, eye surgery, or a second opinion that can be so important, call these folks, 770-964-3391. That's the only number you will ever need for excellent professional eye care, the Fairburn Eye Clinic, 770-964-3391.
Hi, I'm Dr. Tom Cooper. You've heard me on Ludlow's show many times talking about weight loss and nutrition. I have four clinics in Georgia, in Griffin, Marietta, Albany, and Waycross. We now have some very effective and safe ways of helping you take off your weight. For information about these methods and about my locations, call my Marietta office at 770-952-7681. That's 952-7681.
Hi, gang. This is Ludlow Porch, and I need to tell you about my new friends at AutoSave Car Rentals. Their name tells the whole story. AutoSave. AutoSave. They can save you in so many ways. Let me tell you about a few. First, they save you when you need a car, truck, or van at a minute's notice. Second, they save you with cash rentals and unlimited mileage. So, if you or someone you know under 21 years of age, they can save you because AutoSave rents to under 21 folks. They're locally owned and operated with locations all over Atlanta. Open 6 days a week to serve you, and if you need them to, they'll come to your house and pick you up. I want you to mention the Ludlow Porch discount, and you save another 10% on daily or weekly rentals. AutoSave. Look for them in the Yellow Pages. They're all over town. I really love these guys. AutoSave, the name tells the whole story. You call them when you need a car. Murphreesboro, Tennessee, to the studios, WGNS, 1450 AM, and talk to my buddy, Bobbi. Hello, young lady. How you doing?
Well, good morning, buddy. How you doing?
I am great. Hadn't heard from you in a while.
I know. It's just, you won't believe it, but Bart just really have been keeping me awful busy here.
Why wouldn't I believe that? I believe that.
But I want to tell you, I always get to enjoy you. And I understand that when you come in here, that someone's going to be having you a tomato pie made for you.
That's right.
I'm looking forward to that, Luddy. Will you share?
I will share that with you. Listen, I have to, because you fixed us breakfast last time. It just knocked our hats off. So you get half of that pie, I promise.
Oh, okay. But I do want to share something with you with one of our chores of when I was coming up. You know, I don't know if you might remember these white things with the top to them that you'd have to slide under your bed or sit at the foot of your bed at night.
Oh, yeah.
But it was my job always to take that out, wrench them out, and make sure the sun shine in them all day long. And did not like that.
No, no. And
that was not one.
That's one of those things that you never get used to either.
But you know, being the youngest in the family, that was always a chore for the youngest one. And then the next thing, I had a brother, and he loved to play, and his chore was to bring the wood, stack it in the box behind the stove, and on the porch. My grandfather always cut the wood.
Mm-hmm.
But he would play until it was dark, and then, knowing he was scared of his own shadow, then he didn't want to go to the wood pile, and my mom would make me go out there with him. I would fuss, and I'd taunt him, "You better come on. You better hurry up." I let him get a big armload of wood, and then I'd take off to that. He'd drop his stick.
Oh.
That was mean.
Yeah. Yeah, but that's the reason God gave us little brothers, to tantalize and drive nuts.
But he really was my older brother.
Oh, really? Oh, that was even better.
But he would stay out and play, and then I didn't think it was fair that they make me stand out there with him.
Got to tell you a true story. My grandmother sent me after the eggs, and she said, and I was little, this was probably my first trip after the eggs, and she said, "Do not disturb those hens on the nest. Just very, very quietly and sweetly reach under them and pull the eggs out." Now, see, I knew about chicken snakes. I had heard all of those stories about the snakes getting in the nest with the chicken and eating the eggs. The likelihood of me sticking my hand under a setting hen was just almost nothing, but you didn't tell my grandmother no. So I went down there and eased up there, and there were about three of them that I knew I was not supposed to disturb. So I eased out in the corner of the chicken lot, and I found me a stick about three times as long as I was. And I put it under my arm and held it forward like a lance, like I'd seen them do Sir King Arthur. And I beat those chickens off of that nest. I never got caught at that, and it was years before I was told that story, but I would have been summarily executed if I'd have been caught at that, because I'm sure that those three hens never laid another egg.
But I'm going to tell you a secret to that, Ludlow, and if someone out there is listening, I learned from my granddad. He had like this forked stick,
yeah,
that we could kind of put under the hen and raise her up gently. You know, it's like you would make a slingshot.
Yeah.
And you could just kind of push it under, and she would rest on it, and you could lift up enough to...
You were just smarter than me.
No.
I felt like physical violence was the only answer.
But I tell you something, Ludlow, I thank God for those times. You know, although it might seem hard, but it prepared us to appreciate what we have now.
Character builders.
No question about it.
It's been a long time since I gathered an egg, but I wouldn't mind trying it again.
I tell you, we didn't have grass, but my grandmother, we didn't have to cut grass, but we had to sweep it. We had to sweep the dirt.
With a brush broom.
Yes.
Yes, you did.
Yes. So you remember all.
I do indeed.
Well, I'm looking forward to you coming, and I really miss you. And Denny just sounds so fantastic. I miss talking to him.
Well, Denny is fantastic.
Yeah, he is. He really is.
If you can catch him sober, one of the nicest folks ever.
Well, he is. And I enjoy talking to
him. We'll see you soon.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Taylor Construction Company, Yang, you call them and never, ever, ever paint again. Let's go to Greenville, South Carolina and talk to Pennsylvania Vince. Hello, Vincent.
Good show. Good show today.
Thank you, Ed.
In Pennsylvania, in my little small hometown, there was three classes of people. There was the haves and the have-nots.
Mm-hmm.
And then there was the upper crust.
Mm-hmm.
Now, they didn't talk to anybody. They worked at the bank and drove big cars, you know. But the poor people, now in my family, there was nine children. And every day we'd get together in the summertime and decide what we're going to do. And one of the things we'd like to do is go up to my dad's sister's place. Aunt Nellie had a machine that was called a mangle iron. Did you ever hear that word?
The name's familiar, but I don't know what it is.
It was a brand name, and I was wondering whether that name mangle came to be a common word when you mangle something, you know, you chew it all up.
Probably, yeah.
Because this machine would iron clothes, like sheets and shirts and pillow slips.
Mm-hmm.
You sit at this machine, and my Aunt Nellie would sit there, and it had like pedals and a big roller, and then there was a flat, like a metal plate at the top that was hot, would come down on these sheets, and they would roll through this machine. They're supposed to.
Yeah.
And, of course, they wouldn't let us in their house, but we'd come and look in the window and watch this machine running. That was a highlight of the summer sometimes. It was. Once in a while.
That was the highlight of the summer?
Yeah. That, you know, you had to find your own entertainment.
Yeah, I guess.
And we'd go watch Aunt Nellie run this machine. It was called a mangle iron. And this thing would sometimes, it would work real good, but then sometimes it didn't. It would get all tangled up. And she only used it a year or so. I think the company must have went out of business. But those were the good old days when mealtime was at 12 o'clock. That was dinner time.
Yeah.
And then supper time was at 4:30. And if you weren't there, that was tough, because the mealtime lasted about a half hour, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And before meals, we'd get together with my older sister was the cook, and she took, you know, she worked in the kitchen most of the time. And she'd find out, like, how much money we had, and then she'd decide what we're going to have for a meal. And then she'd send one of us to the store, 15 cents worth of hamburger, and maybe a bag of flour and a loaf of bread or, you know, a can of beans.
Yeah.
Whatever you could afford. And that's how we went from day to day on a budget like that, according to how much we could afford to buy.
That's right. The budget dictated the menu.
And we didn't have electricity or telephone at our house, but there were some in town that did.
Mm-hmm.
And it was always sort of a goal to get to the point where we could afford electricity. I was amazed and interested at what the Beaver Man said about that, that he thought he was poor, but he had a pool table in a full-size basement. Can you imagine that?
No, I can't.
Back in the early 30s?
I can't, no.
I never even saw a pool table until about the 50s.
I got to go, Vince. Take it easy, buddy.
Good show.
Talk to you. Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. We'll be right back. I don't know where the summer's gone, but I do know that it won't be long before those school bells start ringing and you're going to be out shopping for those back-to-school clothes.
The weekend comes, knocking on the door. Pitter-patter little feet running on the floor. Turning on the lights, making sure that I can see. Tucking on the sheets, ain't no way that I can sleep, say. Grandpa, what's your plan for the day? What about
Milton Crabbe, Brunswick, Georgia, and Bill. Hi, Bill.
Hey, how you doing, little?
Doing good, buddy. How you doing?
Good. Good program.
Thank you.
Experience that I had when I was a child, it was in the heart of depression and no money. But we had an uncle that we thought was very rich. He had a Model T Ford.
Must have been rich.
He was rich. And he would come over on Sunday morning. He and his wife didn't have children. He was my father's brother. And I always loved him. But what happened, he would take the five of us kids, and we were all about the same age, on Sunday morning, you know, and take us on a drive. And he would, in those days, they didn't have drive-ins we're having today. He'd stop at a filling station, you know,
mm-hmm.
on the trip. And he would give us all a nickel. And my brothers and my one sister would buy a big orange or a grape, you know, a knee-high orange. You remember those?
The big ones, yeah.
Yeah, they were the big ones. But I would buy sour balls. You know what a sour ball is?
Yeah, I
did. Big wine balls, you get five of them. You know, today the same thing cost you a quarter.
Yeah.
But I would buy those sour balls, and they would buy the drinks. Well, it wouldn't be 10 minutes after we left that station that all my brothers and my one sister would start crying for my sour ball. And my uncle was smart. He would never make me give them my sour bowl. And I think he wanted to see how long it would take before they caught on and to find out what they should do about it to overcome the situation.
Yeah.
But, you know, it took them almost a year, and he never made me give my sour bowls to the others. You know,
but
he would just sit there and watch.
Just remember the satisfaction you felt when you had something and they didn't.
He taught me something, you know, with little lessons like that in life. He taught me to save money, you know.
Yeah.
And to be careful of how I spent my money. But I tell you, Ludlow, I had three brothers that never learned. I had one that learned about a year, and I think my sister would cry right now if I went to see her with a sour ball in my heart, if I wouldn't give it to her. I've thought of that over the years. I just wonder if that type of thing has happened to other people.
Yeah. Listen, children learn pretty fast that they can be in control if they've got the only pack of gum in the car.
That's right.
Yeah, and they are completely in control and can turn the other children into slaves, bond servants.
That's right. And, you know, my uncle, I always loved him, and he has done a lot in my life as a model, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But I think he understood the situation, and it was a lesson that he was teaching the other children.
Yeah, and a good one.
That's right.
And a good one.
Just wanted to get that in, Ludlow.
Okay, bud, you take
nice
care.
Nice to be back.
Talk to you soon.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Our number, 1-800-572-8255. Don't have enough time left to give somebody a fair shot at this. But if you want to tell us about when you were a child, what did you think only rich people had and some of the problems that you had? Did you have a lost gate key too? We'll be right back. You stay with us.
For some money for the ice cream man. Come on, Grandpa. What you got planned?
for the best in music and in news, weather, and sports, tune to WBIC 810 AM, Royston, Georgia.
NBC Radio News.
This is the Ludlow Porch Show on the Fun Seekers Radio Network, broadcasting from the Falcon Inn and Conference Center in Suwanee, Georgia. Ludlow Show brought to you in part by AFC 1000 Engine Treatment, by Folks Restaurants, and by AutoSave Car, Truck, and Van Rentals. The toll-free line's now open at 1-800-572-TALK. That's 1-800-572-8255. And now, here's Ludlow Porch.
Well, good morning, fun seekers. Glad you are with us as we head into our last hour of the day. We'd like to hear from you. We're kind of centered in on things you thought as a child that only rich people had and some of the unusual problems that you had as a child. I mean, unusual for you, like knots in your shoes. Albany, Georgia, and my friend Julian on the radio. How do you say, Julian?
Hey there.
How you doing?
Fine. Enjoyed our little short visit yesterday.
Well, I'm sorry it wasn't longer, but... Yeah.
Headed home.
Glad you made it all right.
Yeah. When I was a child, I didn't pay any attention to what grown folks had, but I could tell rich people by the children if they had decent clothes, if they had money in the pocket, if they had a bicycle.
All of that.
Yeah. I remember one little boy that was always well-dressed. We were walking home from school one day, and he said something about the clothes I had on. And right out of the blue, I bet him the only nickel I owned that my socks didn't have as many holes as his did. We sat right down on the curb, took our shoes off. And mine looked like Swiss cheese. And his, the only hole he had, where he put his feet in. Lost my only nickel.
Only nickel. Lost your entire life savings.
Yeah. And I believe it was the same boy.
Oh, that's funny.
He would tie his change up in his the corner of his handkerchief.
Yeah.
And twirl it around.
Mm-hmm.
And he would hit us poor folks on the head.
Mm-hmm.
And the teacher saw him hit me one day. And she said, "You gonna let him get away with that?" I said, "You mean I won't get in trouble if I whip him?" She said, "I think he's got it coming." So I lit into him and whipped him real good. The only bicycle I ever had, I wanted one so bad, my brother would get old junkers and put them together and make me and my little brother one.
Mm-hmm.
There was one little boy in the neighborhood. He would ride down a hill and jump off and let it run down this ravine or run it into a brick wall or something.
Yeah.
I said, "What in the world is he doing?" He said,
"Are you crazy?"
Yeah. He said, "Mama said, as soon as I tear this one up, she'll buy me another one."
So he was hard at it, wasn't he?
Yeah. And I had to wait till I got old enough to get a paper out and buy my own before I ever got a bicycle.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah. But, you know, the lessons you learn from that, I learned real early. Nobody's going to do anything to me.
No free lunch.
I'm going to make it. I'm going to make it on my own.
Attaboy. If it is to be, it's up to me. That's as good a motto as you can ever have.
A very good show today.
Take care, Julian. Yeah. I'll talk to you, buddy.
All right.
Bye-bye. Spartanburg, South Carolina, and Maime. Hello, Maime.
Hello.
How you doing?
Well, I'm doing fine.
Well, I'm glad.
I want to talk about the chores we had to do.
All right.
I had to walk about 2 miles to school every morning, and my brother's about 2 years or 9 months younger than me, and we had to get 2 cows before we went to school every day.
Yeah.
And we had to run school out so we wouldn't be late, and we'd be late for our time. On Sunday, we had to milk 2 cows before we went to church on Sunday night. Wherever we went smelling like a cow. But that was the worst chores we had, was having to milk those 2 cows. Let me tell you this, then I had a younger brother, about 8 years old, and in the summertime, he'd have to stand between us and hold the cow's tails, keep them from flapping them in our face. You know how cows do the flappy,
if
you don't know anything about a cow. They'd flap the tail around in your face and cook the birds and everything in it. So we'd have to get my younger brother to stand between us and hold the cow's tails.
Oh, that's a funny
story. So she wouldn't slap us in the face.
That's funny. So bad thing about having cows is they don't know when it's Christmas Day.
No. But we have been that for years, and
yeah.
I just thought I'd call and tell you about it.
I'm glad you...
I enjoy your program very, very much.
You take care of your sweet
okay.
self, and I'll talk to you.
All right, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. Incidentally, that is a toll-free call from no matter where you are listening. Jump in here and join us. Ludlow and Denny, the Fun Seekers Radio Network.
Well, the rumors are true. Baseball is so much better at Turner Field, even an umpire can see the difference.
Yeah, the rumors are true. At Turner Field, there's an interactive booth where you can try to hit a John Smoltz fastball. The John Smoltz fastball. It's a John Smoltz. Yeah, well, you get the idea.
The rumors are true. Turner Field has a picture studio that prints out famous scenes from Braves history with you in them. Use them to impress your friends or fool people from other countries who might actually believe you're on the team.
The rumors are true. The seats at Turner Field are so close to the action, you almost feel like you're in the game.
We need a pinch runner. You, get in there.
Could I finish my pretzel first?
New Turner Field. It's everything you've heard. For Braves tickets now, call Ticketmaster at 404-249-6400.
Hi, gang. This is Ludlow Porch, and I need to tell you about my new friends at AutoSave Car Rentals. Their name tells the whole story. AutoSave. AutoSave. They can save you in so many ways. Let me tell you about a few. First, they save you when you need a car, truck, or van at a minute's notice. Second, they save you with cash rentals and unlimited mileage. So, if you or someone you know under 21 years of age, they can save you because AutoSave rents to under 21 folks. They're locally owned and operated with locations all over Atlanta. Open 6 days a week to serve you, and if you need them to, they'll come to your house and pick you up. I want you to mention the Ludlow Porch discount, and you save another 10% on daily or weekly rentals. AutoSave. Look for them in the Yellow Pages. They're all over town. I really love these guys. AutoSave. The name tells the whole story. You call them when you need a car. Cleveland, Tennessee, and one of the world's foremost sports officials, and my close personal friend, upon further review.
It's good to be out here.
It's a blessing.
There ain't no question about it. It's a true blessing.
It's a blessing to be out.
No question about that.
A lot of folks are not out.
There's a lot of people hemmed up in places that they can't get out of.
That's right. That's made out of a metal.
That's right. They've got people that are with ugly scowls on their faces watching them sit there.
That's right.
And that'd be a very trying experience.
It would for a fact.
I can remember, there's two things I can remember that I thought made folks wealthy. The guy next door to us got a tractor. And we still had horses and mules, and I always thought that'd be mighty fine to straddle that thing instead of wandering around and behind that gee-whiz.
Not only that, but having to feed it and coax it and hate it.
Exactly. Well, I never did hate the animals we had. We always had some pretty good animals, but you always had to look after them better than you looked after yourself because they made the living.
You can get out the kids.
That's right. And I didn't understand that, but they told me that. And my granddaddy had a bunch of brothers, and one of them went to Washington and became a motor man on a trolley car. Well, now, when I was a little old boy back here in the sticks, he'd come in every once in a while, and he wore them two-tone shoes. And I always thought, this old boy's wealthy. He's got on a pair of brown and white shoes.
No
we couldn't even afford one color of shoe polish.
No question
and
about
this
it.
This guy had on two-tone shoes, and he had on one of them little flat straw hats with a flat bill around it like they're wearing these follies on you see on TV. He wore one of them all the time.
A skimmer.
I guess you could call it that.
Yeah.
We called it other stuff. And he smoked them big, long cigars, big old black cigars. And, of course, everybody in the family, well, they sat around making their own. You know, they had their jukes out. This old boy, he'd draw out one of them big old cigars out of one of them plastic cases and lick it all over and sniff the end off of it.
Showing out.
Oh, yeah, he'd show out. And then he'd take a big drag off of it, blow that blue smoke out, and say, boy, that's very good, very good. Never did offer nobody else any. But now, we always thought he was the wealthiest thing there was.
Well, how could he not have been? A man had two-tone shoes, a skimmer hat, and a black cigar.
Yeah, and he wore them funny-looking suits, too. He wore them Pinky Lee suits.
Really?
Yeah, them little houndstooth, red and white, and gray. You know, he wore Pinky Lee suits. He didn't wear a Pinky Lee hat, but...
Only an important man like a streetcar conductor could afford all of that, and you knew it.
Well, we was all impressed by him greatly.
Yeah.
He could drink good whiskey down by the thousands. I mean, he didn't kill nothing. White whiskey disappeared from him just like the plague come through, and all the whiskey disappeared. But he had to get fired up to go back to Washington, I reckon. Anybody that was up there has to stay fired up.
I guess. Well, he...
Hey.
Yeah.
Well, all I can tell you, I tried to take care of Denny. Denny sounded a little bit down in the mouth. He ain't had no camping trips. And he needs to go camping.
Go camping?
That's what he said. He wanted to go camping. He likes that camp food. And so I'm sending him... Well, I'm sending him two cases of potted meat.
Uh-huh.
And a box of Spam and a stick of crackers and a piece of hoop cheese. He ought to be in good shape time he gets back.
I had a conversation with the Lord when I was in the Marine Corps.
Oh, did you?
He said, if you'll let me get back indoors and stop sleeping on this ground, I won't trouble you with any camping trips, any of those problems anymore. And he did, and I hadn't.
Well, my wife, when we first were in the throes of matrimony,
mm-hmm.
She said to me, we need to go camping. And I said, like a fool, why, of course, honey.
Bless your
heart. So we eased off up into the mountains. Well, after about the third or fourth hour at the place, I said to her, we don't need to do this anymore. I've enjoyed all this I can stand. And
mm-hmm.
So we packed our little ditty bag up and come back. And I said then, my idea of camping is a penthouse suite at the Sheridan with room service, please.
I promise you, you've got to pass an awful lot of hotels to get to any camping ground I know about.
Well, the only way I'm going to camp is if the car breaks down in the middle of absolutely nowhere. I might lay down on the ground and go to sleep if I got good and sleepy,
while
but that'd be the only way.
While you're waiting for AAA.
And while I'm waiting for somebody.
Eddie, huh? Been there, done that. Our number, 1-800-572-8255, the Panthers versus the Falcons. Just the name of the team conjures up that regional rivalry. We're going to get a bunch of Panther fans in here for that game, Sunday, September the 7th. And if you'd like to save yourself $5 per ticket and sit with some of the wackos, a $30 ticket for $25, here's what you do. 1-888-333-4406. 1-888-333-4406. Ask for Joe, and he'll fix you right up. The Panthers are coming in here, and the Falcons are going to spank them like they just stole the government check.
There's a brand new product you need to know about, because no matter how good of a housekeeper you are, parts of your home are natural places for lingering unpleasant odors, like bathrooms, closets, closed pet areas. You get the idea. Well, FanFresh is a small, lightweight, battery-operated fan that mounts a wall and eliminates odors 24 hours a day. Call 1-800-237-8400, extension 102, just $29.95 plus shipping. Call now and get your first refill cartridge and battery free. Fan Fresh.
Hi, I'm Dr. Tom Cooper. You've heard me on Ludlow's show many times talking about weight loss and nutrition. I have four clinics in Georgia, in Griffin, Marietta, Albany, and Waycross. We now have some very effective and safe ways of helping you take off your weight. For information about these methods and about my locations, call my Marietta office at 770-952-7681. That's 952-7681.
Living in the city ain't never been my idea.
South Carolina, and Olin on the radio. Hello, Olin.
Ludlow, how you doing?
I'm doing good, bud. Good. You all right?
I just want to tell you about some rich people that used to play golf in Hampton over here. I used to go by that thing when I was about 4, 5, 6 years old in my daddy's old 38 Ford day. And just wondered how in the world you ever got into a place like that. And another thing, you used to see these rich kids wear these knickers. I don't know where you remember knickers.
I do remember knickers, huh?
And that was about the funniest side, and everybody wore them. They call them sissies over here.
Well, I think the same thing over here.
But anyhow, I was talking to another boy about some of the games we used to play. You played the marbles, I know.
Oh, yeah.
Played a little marbles and then played for keeps. And that's when you went home without any. And you used to play nooks. Have you ever played the game of nooks?
Was that a form of marbles?
Yeah, well, what you did, you balled your fist up, put it down on the ground, and you shot the marble against the other boy's nooks till they bled.
Oh, no way.
Ever who lasted the longest won.
All right, yeah.
And you used to get the old ball bands out the mill.
Yeah.
Over here and use them for steels and the big old, they used to call them log rollers.
Oh, the big ones?
Yeah, the big ones.
Yeah.
Jawbreakers, what they call them.
Yeah, yeah.
Good time to take a load.
All right, buddy, call us again.
Right.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255, Rome, Georgia, and the Rome Wildman, Jim. Hello, James.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How you doing?
Oh, I've been fine. Let's see, it was the best of times and the worst of times. Who said that?
You did. I heard you. We taped it.
Okay. Growing up in a mill village, it was kind of fun sometimes. You know, people used to think people in the mill village was just white trash.
Uh-huh.
They're not true, of course. And but my dad was at kind of at the bottom of the pecking order in the management, so I wasn't deprived of anything I really needed. But there was a lot of things I envied, envied people for.
A lot of things you wanted.
Yeah, that's right. Now, when they built these houses, the plant figured that the people that moved into them weren't used to indoor plumbing.
Uh-huh.
So these toilets would flush whether you wanted them to or not.
I see.
You sit down on the thing, and when you got up, it goes, you know.
Oh, that's
violently.
A wave of the future.
Yeah. And there was a time when I thought grass in the yard was pretty nice.
Mm-hmm.
And when they tried to, it was just slate. And when they tried to make it grass and put the, you know, all this fertilizer on it.
Yeah.
And some dirt. And what grew up, in the interim, there was corn and oats and all kinds of stuff. It was just embarrassing as all get out.
But if you cut it close enough, it looks just like grass.
Yeah, it might have been. might have even been a little bit of kudzu in there.
Yeah, no telling.
Now, you're talking about skate keys?
Yeah.
You're wearing cheap shoes. It didn't matter whether you had a skate key or not.
Oh, I had a terrible time keeping them on, even when I had a skate key.
Well, I mean, I spent a lot of time waiting for skin to grow back.
Oh, yeah.
Between that and I did have a Schwinn bicycle, I'll say that for myself.
Oh, that was the Cadillac.
Oh, yeah, and central heat now. Yeah.
Yeah, oh,
no,
yeah.
No fireplace or anything like that. There's a friend of mine that lived in a silk stocking block in a basement. You know, his own workshop, but he's too dumb to do anything.
But he had a nice shop.
But he had the opportunity if he had any brains. And now, I was talking to Big Red about this, and she said she thought that anybody with $100, that was just about it.
You mean anywhere in checking accounts, savings accounts?
That's right, $100 was the magic figure, you know.
Yeah, if anything happened to you physically, you could live off that forever.
Right. Now, my dad absolutely despised my mother's kinfolks. And for good reason, because they lived up there in Rossville, Georgia, and they thought that people that lived in mill villages were, you know, pure trash and poor.
Yeah.
So when they visited, they brought a sack of groceries.
They bring that to y'all or for them?
Yeah, they bring it to us. They bring a sack of groceries. And it made my dad so mad.
I was going to say, I bet they wasn't out the door going home before we started cussing.
They wasn't very long before they were going out the door.
Uh-huh.
And I don't really have an awful lot to complain about. I got some
every whooping I ever got, I think I deserved it, you know.
Yeah.
And I was the world's greatest procrastinator when it come to doing chores.
Oh, yeah, and me.
And I was supposed to empty the pan on the ice box. I had the same problem you did, except I didn't have enough dexterity. It just went on the floor.
And then it got on your belly.
And I went to the store till real late one night, and I had to come back through a little old shortcut. It's pitch dark. I had a little old flashlight that wouldn't hardly have burned. And I'm making one of them little graveyard whistling noises.
Yeah.
And I ran right slap into something warm and hairy. It went... And an old mule had his head sticking out over the fence.
Oh.
And I ran into that thing. And I do not remember the rest of the trip because dark and all, I mean, I made good time.
You loped home.
Oh, my.
Funny story.
I'll tell you what, whoever has the saddest story ought to get a testimonial dinner.
All right, John. Like Red Button.
Right.
You take care of yourself. I'll talk to you. Bye-bye. Hey, gang, take the night off from cooking. Let folks' restaurants serve you. Let's go to Newton, North Carolina, and talk to my pal, Gary. Hello, Gary.
Good morning, Ludlow. How are you?
Got about a minute, pal.
Okay, it's a quick story. When I was real little, about 4 years old or so, my dad, it was during the Depression, he held down two jobs. And his regular job, he was worked for a contractor. But off hours, he took care of farm at the
Gary,
bank
that, at Yeah, I don't want to rush you. Let me put you on hold, buddy.
All right.
I'll put you on hold. We'll get right back to my buddy Gary in Newton, North Carolina, right after this. It's that time, gang. Back to school time, and that means back to school clothing. And we all know there's only one name for all your back to school shopping, and that's J&R Clothing. They have names like Lee, Levi, Calvin Klein, just to name a few. Great selection of denim jeans and shorts, and a huge selection of husky sizes for those hard-to-fit kids. Hey, you're going to save at least 30% every day. That's 30%. And right now, you get a free logo t-shirt with the purchase of two denim items. And their layaway program, it's available right now. You remember this for your back-to-school shopping. It's J&R Clothing. Two locations, Georgia Highway 85 South at the Clayton-Fayette County line and in Douglasville on Highway 5 and Stewart Parkway. J&R Clothing, your one stop for all your back-to-school clothes. Mama, day, all the children, J&R Clothing. You go by there, and when you get in the door, you tell them a Ludlow Porch sent you.
Does a lack of mobility have you feeling like a prisoner? Break out with a Rascal electric scooter or power chair from Electric Mobility. Go when you want to, without relying on others, indoors or out. Shop, visit, dine out, right around your house and yard with comfort and style. Rascals feature easy-to-use just one-hand controls, super comfort seating choices, a built-in battery charger, and are easy to take apart for transporting in a car or van. Expensive? No way! With no money down in our special financing plan, you could be riding a Rascal for around $2 a day. Isn't your freedom worth it? Plus, if you qualify, Medicare or private insurance may reimburse up to 100% of the purchase price. Right now, you can try out a Rascal for free in the comfort of your own home. Call for your free home demonstration of the Rascal now. We'll send you a free catalog and tell you about our special introductory money-saving offer.
Call toll-free 1-800-340-4455. That's 1-800-340-4455. Call now, 1-800-340-4455.
Listen, it's okay to hassle with a handheld trimmer now and then, or even a small wheels mower, as long as you stick to short grass. But now you can have the best of both machines in the revolutionary two machines in one DR trimmer mower. First, the DR is a trimmer that rolls light as a feather on two big wheels, takes the load off your back while you do all your trimming. Second, the DR is a heavy-duty bladeless mower. It clears rough areas, roadside ditches, tall weeds, brambles, even wet grass without clogging. There's no steel blade to bend or dull. So now, with this one machine, you can take control of your property like never before with the revolutionary two machines in one DR trimmer mower. call toll-free 1-800-254-0700. That's 1-800-254-0700 for your big color catalog and free video all about the revolutionary two machines in one DR trimmer mower. That's 1-800-254-0700.
Buddy Gary is hanging on. Gary, I thank you for holding, buddy.
Well, it's my pleasure.
Because I put you on, I was a minute off in my timing.
Yeah.
Go ahead, start over for us.
Okay, well, when I was a kid, about 4 or 5 years old, it's during the Depression, the early 30s, my dad worked two jobs, and the second job was taking care of a farm where they had 17 head of cattle and a couple of horses and stuff. And, during the off hours, he would... I'd get up at 4 o'clock and go milk the cows and put the feed down for them in the wintertime. And then come home, and he'd have breakfast with, his breakfast was pork chops and potatoes and the whole works.
Mm-hmm.
And then when he came home in the evening, he'd take care of milk the cows again. And part of my job was, Mom, you'd take us over about time for Dad to come home, and we'd let the calves loose and take them to their mothers just for them to feed.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there's one little bull calf there one day. He kind of got away from me, and he pulled my feet out from under me. And I was bound and determined he wasn't going to get away, so I'm hanging on to the rope, and he's dragging me all through the back of the barn till he got to his mama, and they came, those little trenches they had. He stopped me right there.
But he knew where he was going. And
yes, sir. And he was going to wait for me one way or another.
Yeah, that's funny.
And then another time in the wintertime, Dad, of course, weekends, he'd take all the stuff he cleaned out of the drop, and we'd take it out in the fields and spread it.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just one morning. It was cold. There's snow on the ground, and we're using a box sleigh. And all it was like one big box. And you took and put all the manure in the back of it. And the seat was almost just like a board. Well, you know how horses get in the wintertime when they don't get out and get a lot of exercise.
Uh-huh.
Well, they're going along just at a nice, comfortable walk. And that wasn't enough to please me. So I went like that. And they took off with a start. Well, I took off in reverse and went over backwards on that board.
Uh-oh.
And I got up and I was spitting and wiping. And my father almost fell off the seat laughing at me.
Oh, funny stuff. But yeah, they get frisky on you in the cool weather.
Yes, indeed.
Gary, I appreciate you holding, buddy. Good story.
Okay.
Take care. Thank you. Hang in there.
Right.
Auto Save, car, truck, and van rental. Local folks with 6 Atlanta locations. Let's go to Rome, Georgia and talk to Pat. Hello, Pat.
Hey, how you doing this morning?
I'm good. You okay?
Oh, yeah, I'm doing great.
Good.
How about you?
Wide open.
One of the things that separated us was school. The kids that had the bread that was sliced for sandwiches, and we had to carry biscuits.
Mm-hmm.
And they called us biscuit eaters. You remember that?
I remember hearing about it, yeah. Yep, yep, yep. And you'd love to have one of those biscuits today, wouldn't you?
Oh, yeah, I sure would. That's what we had for lunch was biscuits and sent to the garden to get a tomato.
Yeah.
And we were never under Mother and Daddy's feet either. We made our own toys. Did you ever make your own slip?
Oh, yes. Only kind I ever had.
Did you make your kite?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, same way.
Did you ever dam up a creek for a swimming hole?
I'd like to do that again. That was the most fun I ever had. We used to do that 5 times a summer.
Yeah. See, we knew things that kids nowadays, they don't have as much fun as we did. They don't know what rabbit tobacco is.
Maybe they're better off on that one.
Probably true. My daddy hated the smell of it. And in the wintertime, you know, it would get dry in the fall, in the winters, when we'd go out and take some and strip it off and roll it up in brown paper bags and set it on fire. And like Clinton, I don't think we ever inhaled, but we enjoyed blowing the smoke through the...
I thought you were a grown-up.
Yeah, through the latch hole back into the room where Daddy was.
Yeah.
Just to be mean.
Uh-huh. And he remembered.
Yeah, he didn't like it. Our yard didn't have grass. We used a brush broom and just, you know, swept it that way.
Mm-hmm.
And we found whitewash, a big old can of whitewash one time. And our house was gray clapboard. And we got one side of it painted with that whitewash, and we thought that looked great.
What'd your daddy think?
Well, we couldn't sit down for a while.
He didn't think it looked as good. You take care of yourself. I'm glad you called.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
1-800-572-8255, Williston, South Carolina, and Don on the radio. Hello, Donald.
Hey, Ludlow, how you doing?
I'm doing good, buddy.
That's great. Man, the lady that just called sounds like she grew up with me. that's what I was going to say. We used to have more fun with no money than we ever did with money. But my cousins and I up in Landrum, South Carolina, we used to take a hubcap and put a string through the hole and hide in the bushes beside the road, and when a car went by, we'd throw that out in the road, and it'd make all kinds of noise, and we'd yank it back in the bushes, and it was really funny watching these people walking up and down the road looking for a hubcap.
Oh, that's one of those seemed like a good idea at the time.
Oh, yeah, well, yeah. We got caught by the police one time, and it wasn't a good idea after that.
No, I wouldn't think so.
But we had all kinds. My best years were spent at my grandpa's farm, and he didn't have any running water or any indoor plumbing or any of that kind of stuff, and it wasn't like chores back then. It was all fun, you know?
Yeah, well, you didn't think of it as chores.
That's right. I know my grandma hated wash day, but boy, we loved it, drawing water from the well and heating it up in a black kettle. And
isn't it funny how little kids are fascinated by a well?
Yep, it sure is. those were the good old days. And like she said, these kids nowadays don't know what they're missing. They don't even have a good clue, you know.
If you told one today that you wanted to swap his computer for an hour playing at the well, he'd think you're crazy.
That's right. Okay, well, you have a good day, Leslie.
All right, Don, glad you called, buddy.
Right, bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. More right after this. Well, school be starting back soon, and that probably means you're about to get back into the old carpool game for another school year. Hey, this year, do it the fun way in a brand new Jeep or minivan from Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth, in nearby Jasper, Georgia. Big selection of Jeeps in every minivan that Chrysler makes. Listen now, low prices, you betcha. Service department, 5-star, and don't ever forget Jasper Jeep is the home a one-price shop. One price, that means no hassle, no haggle, not even any negotiation. Just good folks who want to sell you your next new car. Now, then they open 8 to 7 Monday through Saturday, but never ever on Sunday. So no matter where you live, you remember, your automobile dealership is in beautiful Jasper, Georgia. So get your back-to-school clothes, back-to-school lunch boxes, but don't you forget your back-to-school Jasper Jeep.
This is Luke Warren from my new friends at Smoky Pig Barbecue in Dunwoody. Smoky Pig Barbecue has been in business down in Columbus since 1953. And now I'm pleased to announce their first Atlanta franchise is open and ready to serve you. Smoky Pig Barbecue is consistently voted one of the top 10 barbecue restaurants in Georgia. My buddy Jeff Burgess tells me they can cater any event from 5 to 5,000. You can order chips barbecue, bite-sized barbecue, or whole slice barbecue. Your choices range anywhere from a sandwich plate or Q stew plate up to a half-pound plate or 10-ounce plate. Smoky Pig Barbecue hours are Monday through Saturday from 10:30 to 8, and they are closed on Sunday. Take I-285 to Dunwoody and take exit 22, which is Shallowford Road. It's located on Savoy Drive, 3 doors down from the bowling alley. I've eaten at Smoky Pig Barbecue, and it's good. Tell them Luke Warren sent you, and they'll probably let you eat there anyway. Mmm.
Mississippi, surrounded by no pity. His parents give him love and affection to keep him strong, moving in the right direction.
1-800-572-8255, Cumming, Georgia, and Pat on the radio. Hello, Pat.
How you doing, Dick?
I'm doing good. You all right?
I'm doing great.
Good.
One thing when I was a kid that was a separation was running boards and not running boards. We had a car that had running board, old 35 Chevrolet.
Yeah.
I grew, so I hated that thing. And, of course, later years, I wish I had it.
Oh, yeah.
But everybody seemed like that they had anything, a car that didn't have a running board on it. And
in your young mind, that became the status symbol.
That was the status symbol of all. When we finally did get one, I think I smashed my fingers in there the first time.
You know, isn't it funny? Isn't it funny what we looked at? That is similar. Like the guy talked about the two-tone shoes a while ago.
Right.
He knew only rich people could afford two-tone shoes.
I know. It's real strange. And, of course, it's like I tell everybody, I didn't realize that we didn't have a whole bunch until TV came along. Mm-hmm. And I seen how everybody else lived, or supposedly lived.
Yeah, leave it to Beaver. They were all rich.
Right. And got one quick trivia thing for you on Beverly Hillbillies TV program.
All right.
Black and white version, color version. When it first comes on, you know, they're coming out of the hills, I mean out of the cabin and running off to Hollywood, mm-hmm. or Beverly Hills. There's in them too. Well, there may be more than one, but the one thing that I noticed was in the black and white version, there's a deer grazing at the front porch. In the color version, there's not.
I'll have to watch for that.
I noticed it one time, all of a sudden there it was, and...
I never noticed.
And one other quick thing, you ever heard the song The Burning of Atlanta by Claude Keith?
No.
It came out in around 62 or something like that. You'll have, put me back in hold and have Danny give me the address. I'll send you a copy of it. I think you'll like it.
All right, good. I'll do that.
All right.
All right, take care, buddy.
Bye.
Danny, he wants to get the address. He's going to send us a thing over there. 1-800-572-8255 is our number as we go to Blue Ridge, Georgia, and talk to Doll Baby. Hello there.
Hey there, how are you?
I'm fine.
I'm going to share one of my worst chores I had as a child.
All right.
Was going and having to feed the hens in the chicken yard when Daddy had...
Uh-huh.
Because them suckers would get you every time. And it didn't, if Daddy would cut them old burrs, or you know, those old furs off them or not, they'd still come up attack you.
And they were still scary. Even when they didn't attack you, you were worried about them.
One day, one didn't worry no more because my mother had got tired of hearing us complain about it. So she said, I'll take care of that. So she went in with us, and he no sooner went after us, and she just whipped around there and grabbed him and just wrung his neck.
All over. One move.
Yeah, one move.
Yeah, I can remember seeing my grandmother do that, feeding chickens, and suddenly there was one flopping around on the ground, and I knew he was going to be on the supper table.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I'll tell you one of the, you were talking about you thought that was fascinating, was the well.
Yeah.
That was the most frightening thing for me as a child.
Really?
Because when we first moved on the farm, all they had across the well was boards.
Uh-huh.
And all I could see was this big black hole. That's just a little bitty thing. It just scared me to death. Mom always said, don't you go to the edge of that because you'll fall in.
Right. You
and
got
I
all
still,
the warnings, yeah.
Still had that fear even after they built a little well box on it, you know?
Yeah.
As far as clothing dislikes, I hated saddle oxford. Hated it.
Why?
Because I wanted what everybody else had.
Oh, okay.
And they were called Mary Jane. They were little straps, little strap shoes.
Yeah.
Had a little buckle across them.
I know what you're talking about, yeah.
And I had to wear a dumb old saddle oxford because they had to last me all year long.
And they were tough. They were tough.
They would last us.
I'm glad you called, my friend.
Thank you, dear.
See you later.
Have a good day.
Thank you.
Bye.
Gadsden, Alabama, and my buddy, Ralph. Hello, Ralph.
Good morning, hello.
How you doing?
Oh, just fine.
Good.
You're bringing back a lot of memories here.
All right.
About a little pre-World War II, anybody that had dry cereal, they were rich. They weren't eating oatmeal.
Oh, that's
that,
funny.
That stuff cost, like Wheaties cost a quarter a box.
Yeah, and there were only three or four kinds. There was
Corn Flakes.
Yeah, Kellogg's Corn Flakes and Wheaties and several of them, but not, you know, you go in the store now and you see 50 different kinds.
And different flavors in each kind.
Yep.
And people with an automobile. I was born, brought up in Chicago, and there's about 50 houses on the block, and about four owned automobiles.
Mm-hmm.
And they wouldn't be, we'd play baseball in the street till 5:30, 6 o'clock at night when the one or two of them would drive in, we wouldn't dare hit their car.
And whenever a car came by, you regarded it as an interruption of your game, whatever.
Oh, no, cars didn't come by. They, the only ones come there was the ones parked on the block.
Okay.
And people had credit at the local corner store. And the rich kids, they'd say, put it on my mother's bill. Mm-hmm. They'd buy a soda pop.
Oh, that, listen, that was a, that better than having a credit card.
Oh, that was a credit card.
That's
that was
funny.
A pre-plastic credit card. And all landlords had money.
Or you thought they did.
Well, that was the impression, because
yeah,
they had
sure.
Your money and theirs.
Absolutely. couldn't go wrong.
And earlier, a guy called about a mangle iron.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that was made by Thor, T-H-O-R. In Chicago.
Oh, really?
And they made wash machines, too. And my mother had one years and years and years. And
I've seen pictures of them. It looked like they were more trouble than they were worth.
Oh, they were beautiful for bed sheets and, you know, linens.
Yeah.
All your napkins and stuff like your linen napkins. But they just put right through there in a flash. But they weren't much good for... My father was a police detective, had to wear white shirts. And
only one way to iron that.
Oh, yeah, that was, she could run the sleeves and part of it, but the collar and the shoulders and all that, she'd had to do by hand. But that mangle, in the wintertime, I used to love to go in there and feel that hot gadget and put your hands on there to warm up.
I got to get out of here. You take care of yourself.
Okay, that'll
talk
bye.
To you soon. Our number, 1-800-572-8255. More conversation right after this. Hi, Fun Seekers. Ludlow Porch with a question for you. Are you going to be too busy to cook tonight? Let folks do it for you, because the good-to-go chicken dinner includes everything you need. Blue ribbon fried chicken, southern-style vegetables, homemade biscuits, and our world-famous iced tea. Now, with 17 Metro Atlanta locations, that means there's one near you. So when you think about a good southern dinner, you think about my friends at Folks. I want to tell you about AFC 1000. That's Anti-Friction Compound 1000. It's new and it's going to help you. You put this in your car engine and then sit back and watch it. It's going to reduce auto pollutant emissions by up to 90%. Boost your horsepower. It's going to increase gas mileage by up to 15%. 1-800-351-5508. You call and tell them Ludlow told you to call. 1-800-351-5508.
The rumors are true. Turner Field has a pitching game that measures how fast you throw. And how accurate you are. And how long the bystanders laugh. Well, not really. I mean, about the laughing part.
The rumors are true. The food's so good at Turner Field, you'll think you've died and gone to heaven.
I'll take a big, fat, grilled Italian sausage.
Even if your tastes are a bit more down to earth.
Or in a brat with sauerkraut and mustard.
Depending on who we're playing, there'll be epicurean delights from around the league. Philly cheesesteaks, Dodger dogs, even Maryland crab cakes when the Orioles are in town.
Wow, I wish we'd play somebody from France.
France?
I think that's where they make Pez.
Oh.
New Turner Field. It's everything you've heard. For Braves tickets now, call Ticketmaster at 404-249-6400.
Hi, gang. This is Ludlow Porch, and I need to tell you about my new friends at AutoSave Car Rentals. Their name tells the whole story. AutoSave. They can save you in so many ways. Let me tell you about a few. First, they save you when you need a car, truck, or van at a minute's notice. Second, they save you with cash rentals and unlimited mileage. So, if you or someone you know under 21 years of age, they can save you because AutoSave rents to under 21 folks. They're locally owned and operated with locations all over Atlanta. Open 6 days a week to serve you, and if you need them to, they'll come to your house and pick you up. I want you to mention the Ludlow Porch discount and you save another 10% on daily or weekly rentals. Auto Save. Look for them in the Yellow Pages. They're all over town. I really love these guys. Auto Save. The name tells the whole story. You call them when you need a car. Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. Talk to old friend Bob. Hello, Bob.
Hey, Ludlow. How you doing?
I'm doing good, buddy. You been all right?
Yeah, been pretty good. Kind of hot up here, but we've been all right.
Yeah, not much better here.
Now, listen, back in the late 40s, we used to always get together on Saturday mornings to play football.
Mm-hmm.
Had about a vacant lot down there right in the middle of town, across the street from school. And anybody that, it kept growing, the game would, and it was just a pickup game, but anybody that was rich showed up with a real football helmet and real shoulder pads.
Yeah.
I mean, that was those who were rich.
Yeah.
Because we'd never seen any before.
No.
And we used to, if they showed up with real shoulder pads and helmets, we'd really put it to them.
Well, not only that, but you thought they were professionals and they ought to know better than to be out there and you'd go kill them.
We did that. You have a good day.
All right, buddy. Thank
good
you.
Bye bye.
Bye bye. Monroe, Georgia, and John on the radio. Hello, John.
Hey, Val.
How you doing, buddy?
Doing right. How about you?
I'm doing great.
Good deal. What about the rich who could haul out spools and spools of, or the racks of flags and show you?
Oh, yeah.
And make a big deal of setting up the screen and the projector and darken the lights and bore you to death with 9,000 slides.
What people ought to realize is their slides are only important to them.
Yeah.
It will not take you back to old Vienna.
Oh, exactly.
It will take them back.
But not you along with them.
Yeah.
And above that was the old either Super 8 or 16-millimeter movie projector.
Mm-hmm.
My uncle was the world's worst about doing it. Hope he's not listening. I'm in trouble if he is. He would bring his outfit in a suitcase and haul it all out and set it up with extension cords and those big blazing lights on his shoulder.
A production.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the machine would make so much racket when he was shooting the film that you could it didn't have a soundtrack, but you could always count on that clatter being part of the party.
Oh, yeah. That was ever present.
Yeah.
And I think that's the reason they call them flickers, isn't it?
Yeah.
Partly because of the jumping,
yeah,
and partly because of the noise. Every family had somebody kind of in charge of that thing.
Yeah. And then later it got into the camcorders, the two-piece devices where you had the camera on up to your eye, and then the recorder was part of a belt that you wear around, that wore over your shoulder.
Yeah.
And then the camcorders now. I thought, somebody wealthy was those with that kind of setup for it.
Yeah, my Uncle Bob had all of that, and he was he would take the movies, and I've often thought I'd like to he's long gone now, unfortunately, but I've often thought I'd like to find some of that stuff he took back in those days when I was a little boy and the world was a better place.
Exactly.
Gone forever, I'm afraid.
Mm-hmm.
All right, everything all right in downtown Monroe?
I got my thumb on it.
All right, good. Well, you keep it right there, and I'll talk to you soon.
Take care.
Hang in there.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. All right, we're going to have to get out of here and make room for your more than wonderful local news and the folks that keep you entertained all day long, the station you're listening to right this minute. We'll be right back with you in the morning, bright and early. Want you to make your plans now to be here, and between now and then, whatever else you do today, you find somebody to be nice to.
Seekers, this is Nicholas D. Ainsworth. You're listening to my close personal friend, Ludlow Porch. And that tickles me nearly about to death.
Ludlow again. Just can't wait to hear Ludlow again. The life I love is here in Ludlow with my friend. And I can't wait to hear Ludlow again. Ludlow again. Just can't wait to hear Ludlow again. The life I love is here in Ludlow with my friend. And I can't wait to hear Ludlow again. Ludlow again. That band of wacko goes out on the airway. They're the best of friends, insisting that the only way is the fair way. And that's why I say Ludlow again. Just can't wait to hear Ludlow again. The life I love is here in Ludlow with my friend. And I can't wait to hear Ludlow again. No, I can't wait to hear Ludlow again.
For the best of music and in news, weather and sports, tune to WBIC 810 AM, Royston, Georgia.
NBC Radio News. Full UPS delivery service could be up and running as early as tomorrow now that the company and Teamsters Union have tentatively settled their 15-day strike. The accord was reached at talks in Washington this morning. UPS Chairman James Kelly in Atlanta says the union's concern about creating more full-time jobs was addressed in the deal.
The creation of those full-time jobs is based on an increase in volume, and our first job is to get the volume back for our current full-time people.
But Kelly warned some current jobs could be lost if UPS can't get back all that business it lost during the strike. Teamster spokesman Bernie Mulligan explains it'll take a while for all the strikers to get a look at this deal.
We expect that the process will take 3 to 4 weeks, so it's a while down the road.
Union leaders, though, vote in Washington later today. From Martha's Vineyard, where he's vacationing, President Clinton expected to make a statement shortly on the apparent end to the walkout. And Barbara Porter.
How would you like to be able to read the morning newspaper in 10 minutes? Or polish off a novel on your lunch break? Or read all about your new computer in one evening? Think about that, because when you go through the new Reading Genius Home Study course, you'll read so much faster, you'll be astounded at how quickly you get to the last page. The Reading Genius Home Study course is easy, it's systematic, it takes just a few short hours, and anybody can do it. You'll read 200% faster than you do right now with better memory and comprehension, or your money back. That includes business publications, newspapers, novels, self-help books, even technical reading. This is the same reading technology that's been used by employees at Apple Computer and Hewlett-Packard and average readers who have become some of the world's fastest readers. Reading Genius improves your reading speed and memory by 200% or your money back. Call 1-800-480-5573. Again, that's 1-800-480-5573.
A hearing in Washington is revealing all safety officials now know about the value jet crash in the Florida Everglades. National Transportation Safety Board Chairman Jim Hall had a message to families of the 110 who died as he opened the hearing.
I joined my colleagues on the board in expressing my condolences for your loss and hope that the exhaustive investigative effort you hear about today will assure you that we have done everything in our power to see that such an accident like this never happens again.
But Hall's words are little consolation for Marguerite Dingle, who lost a sister in the air accident.
We're still angry because nothing has been done, and healing, it's very difficult. Healing is still taking place.
Safety officials now admit fire
My household's on a budget. What?
Track expires in 1999. CNN has been looking for a big name anchor to help its ratings. On Wall Street, just before the hour, the Dow up 63.18 at 7866.54. Planet Radio WGST time is 12:03. Donna Pastelli is in the Weather Channel Forecast Center.
Your Weather Channel three-day forecast, partly cloudy with a slight risk of some showers and thunderstorms this afternoon. A high near 90. Slight chance of showers lingers through the early evening, but then partly cloudy and 73 overnight. For tomorrow, variably cloudy. Scattered rain and thunderstorms are expected, but mainly in the afternoon, a high of 89 degrees. Partly cloudy again by Thursday, 87.
Right now, 83 degrees at 12:03. With live support for busy people, I'm Paul Mann. Planet Radio WGST.
Gwinnett County Police reporting accidents 85 northbound at the Duluth Highway and on Satellite Boulevard.